fans here are still looking for positive evidence that Aston Villa are building a team to match. In our soccer special today, Villa meet Midlands rivals Derby County, a game they badly need to win to get their season going. Manager Graham Taylor has been aggressive in the transfer market, both buying and selling. Will end-of-term results prove him right or wrong? Alan McAnally was the first asset to become disposable, £1,100,000 to Bayern Munich. Martin Keown followed, £750,000 to Everton. Coming in to replace them, Paul McGrath, Adrian Heath and Kent Nielsen for a total of £1 million, so the summer bank balance in good shape. But so far, it's not been mirrored on the field. Villa with only 6 points from 7 games, and the manager is well aware of the implications.
Well, you can't stop people, Martin, looking at the league table with only 6 games on. It's a pity, really, isn't it? Or 7 games. But they will look at it. I mean, and I think, obviously, a win will calm everybody down, because these days, I think even more so, you know, so early on in the season, people, as soon as you're at the wrong end of the table, people do start to sort of get a little bit panicky.
Derby County are anything but easy opponents. They won here last year with Dean Saunders amongst the goals, and in general, seem to do better away from home.
Well, we've done extremely well away from home, Martin, and we've produced some good football, and obviously be looking to reproduce it and to obviously get at Aston Villa in amongst their back men and around the outsides of it as often as what we possibly can, and obviously do that from a nice solid base and hope that that's sufficient to get us a result.
Aston Villa against Derby County then, backed up by all the other First Division goals, and our special guest, Emlyn Hughes, will be giving his views. But now it's over to match commentator Martin Tyler as Villa continue to search for the right formula.
Well, Graham Taylor has made 5 big money signings in 1989, but only one, Paul McGrath from Manchester United, is in this chosen 11. 2 others, Kent Nielsen and Ian Ormondroyd, are only substitutes. And 2 more are dropped, Adrian Heath and Nigel Callaghan, who arrived from Derby in February, but yesterday asked for a transfer. Back come 2 of Villa's own products. Gordon Cowans, who's been left out of the past 5 games, and Tony Daly, absent over the same period through injury. Derby are still relying on the squad, which took them to a most creditable 5th place last season, but there is a defensive reshuffle today which sees the return of Mel Sage. Trevor Hebbard is also back. A facial wound kept him out of last Saturday's home defeat by Southampton. And yet another landmark today for Peter Shilton, whose career is so rich in records. At 40 years and 12 days, he becomes the oldest player to represent Derby, surpassing by just one day the previous mark of the legendary Steve Bloomer 75 years ago. Danny Vickers will be hoping for a quieter match than his last assignment. In the second division, 4 days ago, Swindon against Plymouth, he sent off 3 players. Derby County kick off. They did the double over Aston Villa last season. Both games finished 2-1 in Derby's favour. And the match starting here in bright sunshine, with Aston Villa wanting quickly to put behind them a defeat on this ground by Queen's Park Rangers 7 days ago. With Derby also coming from a home loss. They were beaten by Southampton at the baseball ground, but have been getting better results in their away games. And Trevor Hebbard with an early thrust here for Derby, trying to pick the right ball out, and it was Goddard who couldn't round it all off in all that congestion in the centre. Great play by Hebbard. Some terrier-like work from Geraint Williams, winning the ball back from Stuart Gray for Derby, the Welsh international, settling quickly to his particular role in the side. McGrath's header, Olney. Well, Daly will inject some pace into Aston Villa's attacking. And that a very encouraging start from his point of view. He's had knee and ankle problems. Brought up so close to Villa Park. Really an Aston Villa man through and through. Derek Mountfield and Ian Olney trying to make a move there. At the corner that was taken not very successfully by Kevin Gage. Gallagher with a throw. Came off Mountfield. Ben Saunders trying to make up the ground. And certainly, Aston Villa will keep a wary eye on the player who scored in both wins for Derby against them last season. Olney, jumping with right. And leaving out Adrian Heath, Aston Villa have pushed David Platt as a forward. He's been operating from midfield for much of the season. He's up with Olney. And Daly, the ricochet that comes to Gage. And a diving clearance by Blades. Tony Daly coming infield. And Gage whipped it in. Blades got there as Shilton watched. But the England goalkeeper times his move perfectly this time. His next international assignment will shortly be upon him for England in Poland. Crucial match in the World Cup. Michael White. It should be McGrath. But the loose ball picked up by Hebbard. And Saunders has run offside. Manchester United really gave up on Paul McGrath in the summer because of his fitness problems. Price. Right back with a buccaneering streak to his play. Holding off Micklewhite, drawing right out of the centre and winning Aston Villa a corner. Taken by Gray, by McMinn, back where it had come from. Oh, and that's a marvellous save by Shilton from David Platt. From that range, once Platt had made contact, he must have felt that he'd scored. But you have to reckon on those circumstances with Shilton. And he rescued Derby. Yet again. Well, Peter Shilton has been saying over the past few days he feels he's still as capable a goalkeeper as in his early 30s. And there was no sign of any diminishing of reflexes then. That was terrific goalkeeping. And the England goalkeeper has spelt out to Aston Villa exactly what they've got to beat here. Derby wouldn't be too pleased in the way that Platt got to the ball first to make the header. But they have attacking ideas of their own now. This is Micklewhite. Gage and Price between them holding Derby at bay. Forsyth. Here's Hebbard. Saunders. That's a clever knockdown. And Price had to be sure of getting the ball first inside his penalty area. Price in making an emergency stop then. He's hurt himself. Talk of emergency stops, that's exactly what Peter Shilton did a moment or two ago when the ball must have just been a blur. Forsyth. Saunders, but I've given time to bring the ball down. He's hit in a shot that was immediately blocked. Mark Wright. Gallagher. Olney. Daly. And Shilton had to be safe that time. Wasn't what Tony Daly really hoped for, but the ball just died under the crossbar. And at the moment, both sides attacking rather better than they're defending. It's led to a lively opening phase at Villa Park. McMinn. Derby starting the day in 11th place. Bray hasn't kept it up. Really sparked Derby from Oxford United for what many thought were an inflated price, £1 million mark. He's got 5 goals in his first 4 league games for Derby, including one against Aston Villa here. And he's putting some pressure now on McGrath. He gets a cross in. Nice, defended well. Here's Hebert. And Micklewhite needs an early ball. And Price blocked it. Offside. Goddard launches himself into the header. And his back beat Mountfield to the ball. But when Derby do press, they get a lot of players involved in and around the penalty area. Goddard was at the sharp end, but the header off target. Cowans. Johnny Gallagher. Outfield header. Flat. Well, only Vickers was happy to let play go on. Gallagher. Cowans. Reach Daly, Chris Price, the useful early ball towards Olney, and he was trying to guide it down for Platt. Shilton saw the danger, Ian Olney climbed well beyond the far post, and he was well found too. Olney headed it across, Shilton was off his line sharply. Away. Not the kind of ball that Paul Goddard would really appreciate. Cowans. Good ball to Cowans in the side. Villa play very much through midfield. Would, perhaps be surprising to some of Graham Taylor's critics or critics of the label that pinned on sort of football that Graham Taylor's team play. Saunders. One-on-one against McGrath. And the shot swerved, but Fink didn't commit himself too soon. And went with the curve on the ball. Caught it comfortably. Whichever side gets the first goal here, it really will mean a great deal to their morale. Villa are looking for it now. Price. Blades dispossessed. Olney, Saunders turns Mountfield. Needs to thread it through for Goddard, and he's pushed it too far ahead. It was disappointing in the end for Dean Saunders, but he'd produced a little bit of magic to start with. And the crowd rather basking in the sunshine. Being stimulated at this stage of the first half after a lively beginning, but Saunders might change that. Price gets to the ball, yes. Johnny Vickers had a good look, he was close to the incident, Saunders shook his head in disagreement. I feel that if Derby could perhaps press on a little bit more, they could actually take a very firm grip on this game. The signs of the recent poor results getting to one or two Aston Villa defenders. Quite nicely though. Wade waiting while Wright goes forward. Mark Wright pointing where he wants the ball delivered. Blades gets it there too. It's a looping header and wasn't too far away from dropping in on this near side of the goal. Mark Wright is very much the orchestrator for Derby at the moment. Supreme at the back so far, and coming pretty close there with that looping header. There's never been any doubt about the talent of Mark Wright. There was a time when his temperament was questioned. He hasn't had an awful lot of luck in the game either. I remember him breaking a leg, colliding with Peter Shilton when they were both Southampton players in an FA Cup semi-final just before the 86 World Cup finals. Shilton got to Mexico, but Wright didn't. Well, he's giving away a free kick here. Now Olney's going to get some help. He's challenging for the ball in the air from Mountfield, and a late arrival on the scene is McGrath. Gray. Everything ahead of Chris Price. Gage. Olney. Cowans. Nice football from Aston Villa. Oh, and it was very nearly a strange goal. In that it seemed to me to come off Price. But the decision is a corner. Wright has to defend as he was pushed. And gets a warm pat on the back from Peter Shilton. But just before that, Chris Price had been at the centre of some invigorating Aston Villa build-up, and that came surely off Price and really should have been a goal kick. Saunders. Heaven. Got out the furthest forward for Derby. Saunders has anticipated the flick. Williams. Got out, given room to turn. McGrath is the defender he faces. Got out wants to make half a yard for the shot. To do that, he went sideways. I think saw it coming. Platt. Operating at full tilt. Running out of room. And Platt working hard again to prevent the clearance. Sent long by Mountfield, only chasing willingly. Wright calmly dealing with the danger. Blades likewise. Micklewhite and Forsyth linking up cleverly. Goddard. Well, Daly is a real sprinter. And Forsyth found himself the wrong side of Tony Daly. But Derby will be pleased to make Daly defend. Villa will have hoped to have brought him into the game a little bit more than they have done in the first period. Here he is now. And Wright's got the stretch. Platt's got the better of him. He's round Shilton. Right on half time. A great moment for Aston Villa when Derby were almost cruising to the break. And ahead of Chilton they relaxed a little. But Platt, who perhaps of all the Aston Villa players this season has been in the best condition, the best form, and it showed. And that was a real moment of opportunism. And indeed, the last kick of the first half, most of which was conducted in an atmosphere of neither side being in the freshest of form. But David Platt, who'd been denied by Shilton right at the outset of the half, beat the England goalkeeper right on half-time, and that put a very different complexion on things for both sides. At half-time at Villa Park, Aston Villa 1, Derby County 0. Well, at the start of the second half, Villa Park still bubbling because of David Platt's fifth goal of the season. And Mark Wright still smarting from it, really, because it was Wright who lost out in this crucial duel here. And Platt had the composure to find a way wide of Shilton, although the goalkeeper did force him wide. But still, he made light of the angle. And what a timely goal that was for Graham Taylor's team. Because up till then, it has been a pretty difficult first half for them. Wright, who played so well. And now Derby, with their poor scoring record so far this season, have got to redouble their efforts. And McMinn has strayed from right to left, which I don't think he did at all in the first half. Goddard. What Graham Taylor would have said to his team had the goal not gone in. Perhaps there was a rethink from the manager as he went into the dressing room and got a close view of the situation there that's led to a throw to his team. Cowans, that's a quick ball in, and it very nearly bounced on through over Platt for Gray. Sage. It was Platt who, you might have heard, if you didn't see, go crashing into the advertising hoardings, but he's recovered himself. And David Platt is very much in full working order. He just expects the ribs there. Because he seems to be out of the game, down and winded. He responded quickly when half a chance came his way and had Shilton scampering. Michael Wright was hoping that Price wouldn't get there, but he was wrong. Forsyth holding up Chris Price. Holding up his progress. Wright first to it in the air again. Williams winning the ball well, but then giving it away, and Day's doing likewise. Michael Wright with Saunders through the centre, Goddard is onside to the left, and Goddard has made the goalpost judder. He held his position well. The worry for Derby was that Saunders might have strayed offside. Michael Wright picked the right option with the pass, and Goddard with a clear side of goal on a ground where he got the winner last season. But he couldn't get the equaliser here. The post prevented that. Forsyth. Saunders. Michael Wright. Back having to tackle back, and Daly goes down, and that's going to be a booking for Blades. Paul Blades was so concerned there that Tony Daly didn't slip past him and away. Even though it was in Aston Villa territory, for Daly, Gage to the centre, Platt to the right. Price going outside him. A lot of players involved for Aston Villa in this attack. And then Hubbard has tracked back to head away. And McMinn. McMinn was trying to get his body across the line of Gage's run then. And it all got a little bit messy, but it was rightly a free kick to Derby in McMinn's favour. Metaphorically have come out for the second half with their sleeves rolled up. And they're pushing Aston Villa back here. Saunders shimmied infield to make space for the shot, which was a fairly useful one. McGrath was labouring to keep in touch with Dean Saunders then. Saunders on a run. Outfield. Oh, he's given it away to Saunders. Is this going to be an equaliser? And Derek Mountfield is mightily relieved. Saunders curses his own error at the end of it, but Mountfield gave Derby County a clear-cut opening, and Mountfield is telling everyone that he's to blame. I don't think they needed much telling. And Saunders culpable for Derby too, in a different respect. So Graham Taylor is going to make a change. He's going to send on Ian Ormondroyd. And he gets a pretty encouraging welcome. That the two teams found themselves in coming into this match is always going to mitigate against a game of out-and-out pure football, but there have certainly been moments, and this might be another one from Daly. Good defending by Forsyth, helped by Hebert. Goddard. Oh, and still a case of what might have been for Derby. White couldn't collect it, but Saunders wasn't giving it up. McMinn away on the left. He's back with Blades. Sage. Goddard busy to try and get in front of McGrath. He's ear cupped along the way by the Republic of Ireland international. Right. Blades. Saunders. Showing up well. Tony McGrath making room for the shot, but again, Spink saw it coming. It was a good effort. Not one worthy of an equaliser from Dean Saunders. Android. Sage keeping his eye on the ball and not the gangling opponent. Hebert. McMinn was aware that Price was committed. Daly off and running for a few strides. One of those games where it would surprise you if Villa did get a second goal. The truth, they haven't really deserved it. But the moments that will be remembered in this game have gone their way. Gage. They do have a corner. fans on the Holt End getting a close-up view of the action for the first time for some while. So much have Derby been attacking. And Wright, who's been heading the ball so bravely at both ends of the pitch, does it again, and Shilton came out to say well done. Not for the first time. Williams guarding the post. Derby had pulled everyone back for the corner. They now push out. And Wright is first to it. And he doesn't settle just for knocking the ball out of play. This is high pedigree work from the Derby captain. Goddard. McMinn. Saunders! Oh, it was another very good chance. A move started by Mark Wright with some polished play in his own half. And Dean Saunders should have rounded it off. Another opportunity goes a-begging. Gallagher misjudged McMinn's cross, and Saunders did really by heading over rather than down at goal. Derby really don't deserve to lose. McMinn. It's another corner. The pressure hasn't been enough for the team managed by Arthur Cox. Saunders has had a couple of really good chances. Goddard as well, hitting the post and clean through. Hebbard, Wright, Goddard, and again, corner. With 5 minutes to go, Derby County have done everything but equalise. Jumping with Wright, Michael Wright, ball was deflected, and then Spink smothered it from Hebbard at the near post. Well, the chances continue to arrive for Derby. Spink hasn't had to make too many saves, but that was a difficult one for the Aston Villa goalkeeper. All Derby at the last, has been for much of the second half. Mountfield, well, a called handball against Mountfield. It was the crowd as the ball spun up towards his chest. Nothing given. I think happy to get it up the other end of the field. Hebbard, Michael White, now Sage, Hebbard, and another little crisis, passes Aston Villa safely. Well, the message to Phil G can only be go on and get us a goal, son. Given him a great deal of time, 3 minutes in fact, as he replaces Goddard. The need for victory etched all over his expression, but it's very nearly there. Unless Derby can deliver a dramatic finale. Saunders. And maybe G can do it. Will Gallagher get there? G is there first. It's Phil G, and when glory was beckoning for him, his name joins the growing list of Derby players who have missed opportunities in the second half. And in a way, a similar opening to Platt that brought the goal in the dying moments of the first half. Derby's lack of a sharp cutting edge in attack has really been costly in the second half. Gray, happy to keep the ball at this end of the pitch. Or Madroid. Oh, I think Peter Shilton was well aware that it was dropping on top of the goal and not on top of the bar. The Aston Villa supporters are begging Danny Vickers to blow the final whistle. Hebbard heads on. Well, Derby will point to the chances that have fallen to Saunders. And Goddard hit the post. The miss after Mountfield's terrible error, he was so fortunate to get away with. And still they drive on, and Paul Blades, who's only scored one goal for the club, that was a late goal that turned out to be a winner against Coventry last season. But he couldn't deliver such a spectacular shot there. Ormondroyd. The style of victory didn't matter for Graham Taylor. It was a win. Arthur Cox gives his congratulations. David Platt's goal has blown away some of the clouds which have been gathering over the only West Midlands club in the First Division. He came right on half-time and he got the better of a gallant Mark Wright, who didn't deserve to be a loser on the day. And Derby missed a succession of opportunities. But for Aston Villa, a measure of revenge against the club which did the double over them last season. The final score at Villa Park is Aston Villa 1, Derby County 0.
It isn't the easiest thing in the world to put it in there. There are people trying to stop you, there are goalkeepers, all the things that go along with it. But today, the calibre of player that we have, we've wasted an awful lot of chances. Very disappointed, but very pleased with the way we've played in terms of entertainment, football skill, all the things that go along with making a football game. But spoilt the weekend's dinners and all the things that go along with it. I'll be sitting in front of the video now, sorting it out, trying to see what's how we can improve it. Yeah.
This phrase, it's only a game, is a silly sort of thing. But it is only a game, but it happens to be a living. But, I mean, there's so many. What happens today if Saunders had two or three chances? What if he scored with them today? We've lost 3 or 4-1. And all of a sudden the game's no different other than the fellas hit the target. And I'm then the world's worst manager. That's how it is. It's so thin, this line, isn't it, between success and failure, that it's not worth believing either of them. You just get on and enjoy your life.
I was disappointed in the game. I was disappointed in so much as, I mean, I was a defender all my career. I saw so many bad defenders out there today, not knowing danger, not knowing when danger was coming, not knowing when it was lurking, being easy on the ball. And in the end, I mean, Villa have won a game that they haven't played well, but Derby weren't desperate to win it. They never really clawed and fought and scratched to get out there and do it. And in the end, they've got beaten by... I mean, really, I thought it was a poor game.
The one goal, and you mentioned the poor defenders, but perhaps you might lift Mark Wright above that criticism, and yet he was the player involved in the goal.
Very, very much so. Mark was the best defender on the field and played very well. Shilton was superb again, although he had very, very little to do. He made a super save first couple of minutes.
Oh, and that's a marvellous save by Shilton.
But I can imagine that Coxey in there now will be giving them some stick, because they have lost a game, really, that they should have gone and won well. But weren't desperate, as I said. They weren't gritty. They weren't really, never really hurt them. You know, when they lost the ball, it was, oh, sorry. I mean, he'll be laying into them now, for sure.
I used to say at Newcastle, you don't jump in the time when you lose, and, you know, you don't get drunk on all the things that go along with it when you win. Frustrating game, eh?
It is indeed. Well, now it's time to check on the rest of the action in the First Division, and it wasn't a bad day for the Midlands, although we start in London at White Hart Lane. All eyes on Gary Lineker. Is his form returning in time for England's World Cup match in Poland? Mabbott in front of Colin Clark, who's still chasing. Butters will have to hurry. He's found Stewart. That's a nice turn. Lineker left, and Gascoigne arriving to Stewart's right. Here is Gascoigne, and Lineker, 1-0. Lineker's first goal in front of the White Hart Lane faithful.